EK Water Block's all-in-one liquid cooler was an impressive piece of hardware. Meet the competition. Hey YouTube, Danny here with DTC. If you're new to the channel, I frequently do hardware reviews, PC builds, and sometimes perform how-to videos too. Today's no exception. I'm gonna do another hardware review. These seem to work really well for me, and I enjoy looking at new products. So, as I said in the intro, this is the Lian Li Galahad 240mm AIO. This all-in-one liquid cooler is a direct competition for EK's all-in-one liquid cooler as well. They're the same size, pretty much have the same type of components and quality and everything like that, which I'll show you in a little bit. This AIO comes in two sizes and two colors. It's a 360mm or a 240mm, and then you can get them in a white or a black variant. Both sizes come with 120mm fans. The 240mm obviously has two of them, the 360 has three of them. They're high static pressure, they're fluid dynamic bearing, and they're PWM controlled. But enough talking about it, let's open this thing up and do a quick walkthrough. Right away, there's not a lot of components to it. It's just the radiator, the pump, the fans, and the hardware to mount. Real nice, looks real clean. Packaged really well. Seems to be nice quality materials. So your two 120mm fans actually have rubber brackets on the corners here. It's just whether you mount it on the top or on the bottom, it doesn't matter. It's rubber on both sides. And then the fan quality looks real nice as well. It's got two plugs coming off of it. One is their proprietary plug for the RGB. And then the other one is a PWM fan header. You can see the nice pump head. It's actually rotatable in case you want to put the pump a different direction. And then the radiator itself has these nice aluminum plate brackets on here. You can take them off. It's got screws to it, but really, really beautiful looking brackets on these. If you have it displayed somewhere that you can actually see it, it'll look good. But most cases have like a lip that's going to cover that if you mount it top mount or front mount or whatever. Okay, first up, you have your Y splitter that runs both fans on your radiator and then just plugs into your fan header on your motherboard. Pretty simple. So that's for all your RGB pump header cap. It's actually quite interesting how they've designed this. Let me see if I can spin it around and show you here. And you can actually just stick it to it and it pulls in right there. But it's a neat little cap. Maybe I can get the DTC logo etched into that. You've got your bracket for AMD and that just slides on, and I'll do that when I do the install, but because I'm gonna use AMD today. You got screws for LGA 2011. Those won't be used for most people, so you can probably discard those to the side. These are the screws that I'm gonna be using to secure the fans into the radiator. You can see they're a shorter thread pitch. And then here's your backplate bracket. It's universal, Intel and AMD. You can see it says AMD there, Intel there. You have four plastic spacers here, as well as four plastic washers. You have your four captive screws with springs built in to lock down your cooler. You have the two AMD brackets. You have five plastic washers. Hey, I have five. So you have your two AMD mounting brackets. They'll actually lock down through these tabs and then lock down to your stock AMD cooler solution. Like I said, I'll show you in a second. But you'll only use two of these screws then to tie down those. Four screws for your rear mount plate. And then you have tiny screws to secure the radiator to the case. Very, very small screws as well. And that's really it. There's not much to it. So let's put this radiator and fan combo together, and then we'll get it installed on the test bench. For all the thermal testing, I used the same testing methodology I used last time I did the 240 mil testing and all the air cooler testing and stuff like that. I did all the same methodology for that, so it would be very consistent. I used the same hardware as well. And I'm gonna do the same type of a breakdown for what I thought about this and everything. So for style points on the Lee & Lee Galahad, I think it's spectacular. It is an amazing fit and finish, really quality material. Even so, beyond the EK Waterblock one that I got, I don't really want to do direct comparison to them, but the Lee & Lee one definitely has a very nice fit and finish. For noise, it was silent. It worked right out of the box at a silent type setting. There was a little weird thing that I noticed though. On Lee & Lee's website, if you go to their website and check out the Galahad, they've got a note in this section there that says they don't want you to adjust the pump profile in your BIOS. They want you to leave it on DC voltage, whatever it's preset at, which is maxed out. It runs at 3,300 RPMs or whatever. They say it's designed to run at that. And they say that's the silent operation. It is silent. It is a lot quieter than any of the other pumps that I've heard at max speed, but it's still, you can still hear it buzz or hum or whatever. So I wanted to try it, fluctuate it a little bit. And, it turns out when you adjust it on your own in the BIOS, it's super, super quiet. I didn't hear it at all. Now, it has a caveat to that. It changes your temperatures. Obviously, the liquid flow from the radiator to the pump is not as fast as when the pump is running at full speed. So the temperatures, what I'm gonna give you here on the chart, were about 3 to 4 degrees higher when I set my own profile on the pump head. When I did what Lee & Lee said and set it at the max 3,300 RPM speed, these are the temps that I got. The idle temp on the CPU, the Ryzen 5 3600, was 29C. This is when nothing was going on, it was just sitting there idling. When I ran Cinebench R20, it came to 66C. This is max temps that it hit. Blender came to 67, and Unigen Heaven was a nice cool 48. So not too bad on the temperature side of things with this. It's pretty much on par with the EK Waterblock AIO. So either one would be a good option. I guess it really goes down to aesthetics then. When you do your own custom profiles and stuff for your fans and your pumps, the noise is pretty much eliminated on both of them. So really good noise quality, especially when you set your own settings, and temperatures were not too shabby. So getting to the final thoughts on this thing, I think it has great build quality, as I said before. I love the addressable RGB headers. Another good thing is it has a 5-year warranty, which most AIOs do. If you notice the cap, as I said before, I think the magnetic cap looks a little plain and I would love to do some kind of etching on it, but you don't even have to use it. You can just run the Lee & Lee logo. Look at Lee. You can just run the Lee & Lee logo if you want, and that's perfectly fine also. So my opinion of this, I like the Lee & Lee one better than the EK Waterblock one, just because the pump head was much quieter even at 4 RPM. Their style and finish and everything is really, really nice. The rotatable pump head is nice. And I cannot wait to use this in a build. I actually have a case ready for this thing that I want to do something with, but you'll have to wait till next week to check out the case, because I'm pretty excited about that as well. Now, if you enjoyed any of the music that I played today, Epidemic Sound is where I get all my music from. They have copyright-free music, and you can add the music to a Spotify playlist if you want. You could try it out for 30 days by clicking my link below. Finally, I wanted to add this in. Thank you all so much for subscribing. We passed 500 subscribers, and this is a huge milestone for me. I am very excited and can't wait to get more content out to you. So as always, I'm Danny with Danny's Tech Channel, and I'll see you in the next one. Try not to hold me down, feel alive.